In the last couple of lessons, we have been improving the user experience of our application. But all of this isn't enough when you need to go mobile. Let's see how the application looks like in a tablet device. And to do this, I'm going to use these buttons here on the toolbar, the device preview buttons. And these allow you to test how your application is going to look like in different form factors. So for instance, in tablet portrait mode. And as you can see here, our application in a tablet would already have some horizontal scrolling. And if we go into a smartphone mode, you notice that now we have even more horizontal scrolling, and some of the content of the page is already hidden from the user's sight. And I want to fix this. And to fix this, I am actually going to change the theme of my application to use the London theme. The London theme is a responsive theme, which makes it easier for developers to design an application that looks and behaves great on desktop and mobile devices, without having to implement different screens for different form factors. So to do this, let me go here to the theme and change here the base theme of my application from Chicago to London. And you'll notice that, well, first of all, the change is smooth. Your application is still able to publish. There are no errors, so everything changed smoothly. And one other thing you notice, and this is the important part, is that now your content, the content of your page, adapted to this form factor. You no longer have an horizontal scroll on this page. And you notice that the action that we have, for instance, the action that we have to create a new employee, also is also adapted to this form factor. While on a smartphone, we have this icon to create a new employee. If we go into tablet portrait mode, you notice that now we have space here in this form factor to have also the text of the link visible as well. And another thing you'll notice is that on both of these form factors, you see no menu here. There's no menu here. And this is because the menu is actually hidden under this option here. And it slides when you press here, it slides from the right and it shows the options of the menu. Now, let me just change here the size of this container that we changed in the previous lesson. It doesn't work now well on this London theme. So let me just resize this to the 12 columns of our grid and let's see this in the browser. Now, first thing you'll notice is that actually when you are previewing this application on a tablet device, when you go to the browser, you are also on this preview mode. This is not actually your application, okay? Your application is just what's inside this tablet frame here, but this allows you to test on the browser, again, the same form factors you tested when you changed the application. So here it is, our application on a tablet portrait mode. You notice that everything is visible. There's no horizontal scrolling. We have big buttons, and this is to promote the usage of our hand on touch devices. And let's see how this looks in a smartphone. You notice that on a smartphone, now the buttons stack and the inputs, they stack on top of each other to make it easier to input data. Here, the link adapted to this form factor, so we no longer have the text of the link. And everything fits in place beautifully. And you notice that the options of the menu, as I said, they slide from the right, and you have them here. And if we go back to the desktop mode, you notice that everything is still there. Now, we improved the usability of our application. We took it a step further by creating a responsive application. So now our application is also able to adapt to different form factors. There's one final thing that we usually do in our application, which is to customize the look and feel of our application to match our branding of our company. So let's go back and change our application to do this. And to customize the London theme, I'm going to show you how you can do this. Here on the theme, let me open the style sheet. You notice that the style sheet for our application has a link here, and this link, let me click on it, this will lead you to a tool that helps you customize the London theme. And all we need to do to create this customization is to choose the logo of our application. So let me choose our directory logo. And you notice that this tool already adapted to have here the logo that I just selected, and you can further customize this. You can change the main color, for instance. So let's say that we have blue, and you can change the background. So I want a blue background on the other, and you can also change the font and so on. And all you need to do to have this customization in your application is to select the CSS here on this input. Let me just copy it and get back to change my application. I'm going to paste it here. So you have here the instructions. So go there to that link, customize the theme, and then paste the CSS here. Okay, so there we have our application with working on a tablet device, working also on a smartphone, and also on desktop, and now with the customization that we have. So let me just publish this and see our application again. Okay, so here we have our application now with our branding image, and again, everything fits in place, so the inputs now stack on top of each other, and if we go to tablet, we still have the customizations that we did on this page, and if you go to desktop, there we have it. Now, one final thing that I would like to leave you with in this lesson is where you can get more information about this London theme and how to use it. So let me get back here to the application and show you again here on the theme. When you select the London tab, so this is the base theme tab, again you have here another link, let me click on it, and this link will lead you again to the same tool and to the documentation of the London theme. So this is comprehensive documentation about the London theme. It includes how it works, how you fine-tune the experience in different form factors by applying existing styles that you have on this theme, and let me show you that's the final thing that I want to show you, a list of patterns that you commonly use in your applications, and that you can get more information on how to implement them. You can even get the source of this application for you to see how to implement these patterns. And that's it.